One of the most important concepts to understand in blockchain distributed ledger finance is network topology. There are centralized models, decentralized models based on hubs and spokes, and distributed models based on individual peer nodes. This is important because the radical implication of peer-to-peer networks is that any node can deliver services to others for a small transaction fee. Already, this is how transaction confirmation and logging occurs with the mining operation, how transaction ledger hosting occurs, and how some decentralized news services properties such as Steemit and yours operate. The future includes the implication that a new technology like payment channels might allow peer banking services that each node could provide validation and confirmation and transfer of financial transactions to other nodes for a small fee. This is really radical because a payment channel is a concept of a technology in three steps. First of all, there is an opening transaction between myself and another party in a maximum amount of a certain value. Then I book my consumption against this credit payment, this escrow on file. And then the third step is that there's a final transaction of aggregate cumulative net activity, one transaction at the end that closes the contract. It's important because meanwhile there's been, the two parties are contractually obligated and the transaction is open, and then we just merely track activity during the period of the contract and then close it later. So this is a temporal consumption, prepaid escrow consumption contract. I think that there could be at least four different levels of a payment channel. First is a one-to-one party transaction. It's myself and another party tracking expenses over a monthly period, say. Second form, or second level, could be small group payments, where we have three different parties, such as myself and the bartender, my friend and the bartender, and my friend and I playing pool together, in an example that's been used. Instead of having each of us having to settle unilaterally at the end of the night, we all settle on a net basis. The third level is a multi-hop payment graph envisioned by the Lightning Network, where every node might offer peer services, or there might be hubs. And there are some, that is a concept. There are many different ways in which this might be done and in which this might be problematic, but the concept is vast peer-to-peer networks that are financial graphs. Then the fourth level of the concept would be that the smart network instantiates banking services automatically and ambiently, sensing demand, just like Mike Hearn and others have envisioned that self-driving cars might sense network demand for services, automatically instantiate themselves, and start offering services. So because everything is on a trustless computational network, there's no need for human-backed peer nodes. The peer nodes of the network themselves can offer the service. If we think about how the payment channel concept might play out in a wider basis in the economy, it's really quite startling. We could have digitalized money and payments and activity securely forward committed in payment contracts. The implication of this is that the economy could settle on the basis of net rather than gross flows. A net clearing contracts for difference economy could rethink the crippling monolithic debt structures with streaming money disgorged in much smaller chunks, more closely tied to costs and repayment possibilities. Prepaid consumption and 30, 60, 90 day vendor terms could be offset, the prepaid consumption and postpaid consumption models could be offset to facilitate a directed payment graph economy of just-in-time money. Thank you.